Hello dear students, today we will study about some formulas of trigonometric functions. Very very important formula, they are useful for solving questions and also for higher classes. These importance are very very important, these formulas are very very important. Okay, so first some of the formula we know from previous class. Just like sin minus x equal to minus sin x and cos minus y minus y equals to cos y. Similarly, sin 2n pi plus x equals to sin x, cos 2n pi plus x equals to cos x, 10 pi plus n pi plus x equals to 10x. These are formula, few formula there. Now all the formulas are comes from unit circle. So using that unit circle, we can get a basic formula. By using that formula, we can derive many many formulas. So here, first important formula is cos x plus y. Suppose cosine of sum of two angle we want to find, then this is equals to this formula. Okay, cos y, cos x cos y minus sin x sin y. Okay, this is a basic formula. By using this formula we can derive many many formulas. So it can be solved, it can be proved by using unit circle. This is y axis, vertical line, this is x axis. Okay, now take unit circle. Suppose this is our unit circle, just to draw the unit circle very seriously, taking okay, this is center, and unit circle means one radius. Radius is what? One. Just like this. Okay, now this is origin. This we know about in unit circle. If this is point AB, then this is defined as what? Cos of x. If this is x angle, first coordinate cos of x, and this is sine of y. We define in unit circle, if this is angle x, its coordinate AB, this is B. B is defined as sin y, sin x, if this is x, and this is A is defined as cos x. So this point, coordinate of this point is what? Cos x, sin x, we know, based on angle, clear. So here for getting x plus y, x and y both are angle. Here, just suppose this is a point and this is a point and this is a point and this is point. This is point P1. Its coordinate, what? This is 1, so 1, this is 0. 1, 0 coordinate. Its point P2, its coordinate will be cos of x sine of x if this angle is what? According to unit circle, coordinate based on this angle, arc length x, x radian angle. So this is x angle. So first coordinate cos of angle, cos x, sin x. And suppose just we, this is origin, clear? What? This is origin. And this angle P2, P3, P3. Suppose this angle is y. This angle is y. Because we recall x plus y. So this is x and this is y. So x plus y. Total angle. Total. Total is what? X plus y. So from here to here, angle is x plus y. So its coordinate will be cos x plus y and sin x plus y. Sin x plus y. This is coordinate of P3. Because angle is what? X plus y. And its angle also, suppose same angle we make here on negative direction. So this is minus y. Same angle is making here on negative direction. So its coordinate P4, what? Cos of minus y and sin of minus y. Because coordinate based on angle. So cos of angle and sin of angle. So P1, P2, P3, P4. There are four points on this unit circle. Now for getting this formula, just we have to construct two angle triangle and use geometry, then you can get this formula. Very simple. So proof of this formula is not required, but just you have to know how this formula is derived. Okay, so just join P2 and P4. Okay, this point, join this, clear? And just join this P1 to P3. Just join this. Okay. Now triangle OP2P3 in triangle OP2P3 is congruent to triangle OP3P1. O, P3, P1 means these two triangles, not P4, sorry, P4, this O, P2, P4 and O, P3, P1, O, P3, P1, clear? This two triangle, what? O, P2, P4 and O, P3, P1, these two triangles are congruent. Why congruent? Because in this triangle, this is radius, also this is radius. In this triangle, this is radius, and including angles, this is y plus this angle in this triangle. Y plus this, and also in this triangle, this angle is y plus this, means this angle and this angle are same, and included side are also same. So these two triangles are what? Congruent. If these two are congruent, since these, therefore we can write what? P2, P4 means this side is equals to P3, P1. P3, P1. Because OP3, P1, OP3, P1, this is a triangle. Also, OP2, P4 is a triangle. Both triangles are congruent. Why? Because this side and this side and including angle are same as this side and this side included angle. Congruent? Clear? So, if these two are congruent, then it's from side P2, P4 of first triangle and second triangle, side P1, P3. P1, P3, P2, P4. These two are equal. If these are equal, then we can square it. P2, P4 square equals to P3, P1. This is the length of side square, and we can use distance formula for finding distance of P2, P4. So distance formula we know, y2 minus y1 square plus x2 minus x1 square root over. So square, then we can write what? First formula, P2, P4, P2, P4, this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2, x1, y1, x2, y2, P2, P4. So we use formula what? X2 minus x1 cos minus y, x2 minus x1 cos x square plus y2 minus y1 plus y2 means sine minus y minus sine x square. This is because of a square, this is left hand side. Just equals to what? Right hand side. Here point is P3, P1. P3, P1. P3, P1. Okay. So here we can write also P3, P1. So this is x1, y1, x2, y2. So y2 is what? X2 is 1. 1 minus what? Cos of x plus y square. X2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square. Y2 0. 0 minus sine x plus y. Sine x plus y. X1 y1, x2 y2. X2 minus x1, y2 minus y1 square. This clear? Now from this we can get result, calculate. Okay, just we have to calculate now. So this is main thing, this triangle and this triangle are congruent, so sides are equal, and vertex is having or points having coordinate, so we can get distance. These two distance are equal by congruency, so just squaring both sides. So by using distance formula, we get this is equal to this. Just now we have to solve it. Okay, so here can see that cos minus y, we know cos minus theta equals to cos theta. So cos y minus cos x square plus here sin minus y equals to minus sin y. So minus sin y minus sin x square. This first part is equals to here 1 minus cos x plus y square plus here minus sin x plus y square means sin square x plus y. We can write like this. Clear? Now just derive the formula. We can derive formula after this line. Just we write here a minus b whole square means a square plus b square minus 2ab. So cos square y plus cos square x minus 2 cos x cos y. This gives here minus minus both minus, so plus sin x plus sin y. Just sin square x plus sin square y sin square y plus 2 sin x sin y. Just we have to break it. A plus a minus b whole square, here a plus b whole square. Okay, on the right hand side. This is equals to on the right hand side here a minus b whole square. So a square plus b square cos square x plus y minus 2 1. So minus 2 cos x plus y. This is breaking of this breaking sin square x plus y. Okay, both sides are like this. Now our required formula is what? This. From here we can find the result just like this. Here cos square y sin square y. Cos square y plus sin square y equals to 1. Cos square x plus sin square equals to 1. 1 1 2. So 2. Clear? 2. These 2 make 1 1. These 2 make 1. 2 2. 2 minus 2. 2 is minus 2 is common. Then we get cos x cos y. Minus 2 common, cos x cos y. Here minus 2 common. So minus sin x sin y. Left hand side. And right hand side, cos square x plus y, sin square x plus y gives 1. So 1 among 2. 2. Minus 2 cos x plus y. So from here we can get 2 to cancel, minus minus. We can get this is equal to this. Cos of x plus y equals to, that is this, equals to cos of this. Cos x cos y minus sin x sin y. So this is our formula. This cos x cos y minus sin x sin y cos x plus y. So very simple. Just take unit circle. And taking point P1, P2, P3, P4, give this is x, then coordinate y, then sum of x plus y, coordinate, and this negatively minus y, so cos, this is the coordinate, this two triangle are congruent, so these two are equal. Now using distance formula, we can get result that is the formula. So cos x plus y is equals to, this is our main basic formula. Okay, now we will derive more and more and more formulas from our basic formula. Using basic formula, we know some formulas also and values. So first of all, for study of trigonometry, just you have to know all the formula and how this formula are derived what is the basic thing for this formula you require. Okay, so first of all, just formula for sine and cos, a plus b minus b. So there are just you have to write all these formulas in your copy, very very important. So one by one, just I write the formula, just follow it. Sine, here first formula is this, first formula is this, second formula, cos of x plus x, this plus sign for, so now cos of x minus y, cos of x minus y, if we want to require find this value, then we can write like this, what, minus y minus sine of x sine of minus y, because it is proved. Now for finding cos x minus plus x minus y, so take y in place of minus y in place of y, taking minus y in place of y, so here minus y, here minus y, here minus y, so we get what, cos of minus theta equal to, we know cos of minus, cos of minus theta equals to what, cos of minus y equals to cos y, and sine of minus y equals to what, minus sine y, we know. So using this we can get cos x cos y plus sine x sine y, minus minus plus, so here cos x minus y equals to this, so this is for minus formula. Okay, this is second formula, cos x minus, plus then here minus, minus then here plus. Now third formula, we want to find sin x plus y, sin x plus, what will be the value of sin x plus y, sin x plus y, for getting sin x plus y, just we will derive formula one by one. Okay, so here first of all, some formula required, that is we know there are some basic formula for finding the value of trigonometric functions used for 90 plus and minus 180 plus and minus. That means just we require the value of six trigonometric functions, just like sine 90 or pi by 2 plus minus theta equals to, or plus minus x equals to, what will be the value, plus minus means 90 plus x equals to what, and cos 90 plus minus means just this type of formula. Suppose this is what, pi by 2 angles 0 to 90, this is what, 90 to pi, this is what, pi to 3 pi by 2, this is what, 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi, in between here 90 plus angle is here acute angle, if this is acute, simple, minimum value of that, 90 plus 90 minus, here pi minus pi plus, because pi minus value between acute angle, so pi minus here, pi plus here, similarly this is 3 pi by 2, minus here, plus here, 2 pi minus here, 2 pi plus here, so 2 pi plus, we know value. Okay, same value, repeat all. So here first of all, we establish formula for cos of, because we know about cos, these two formula. So we can find cos pi by 2 plus x equals to, and also cos pi by 2 minus x equals to. We can find value from here. Okay, so here suppose first of all minus, because one by one we have want to find the formula. So cos x minus pi by 2 minus x. Cos pi by 2, this is an angle, this is an angle. Okay, so cos a minus b. So cos this, cos x minus y. So here cos x this, y this. Using this formula for here. So cos of this pi by 2, cos of x minus sin of pi by 2 sin of x. Just we get like this. Clear? So cos 90 minus x equals to here cos a cos b, here plus this plus cos a minus. So here cos 90 means what? 0. This is 0. So total 0. Here sin 90 1. So this is what? Sin x. That is cos pi minus 2, cos pi by 2 minus x equals to sin x. We get this formula. Clear? Similarly, for plus sin, we can get formula. What? Cos. If we take plus sin, then here will be minus sin. Here will be what? Minus sin. Then this is 0, cos 90, 0, 0. Here minus sin. Minus sin. That is cos 90 plus x equals to what? Minus sin x. We get this formula. This two formula. Okay. Now using this one by one, using this for sin x plus y, we want to find the value of sin x plus y. Sin x plus y. So sin x plus y, cos x plus y, cos x minus y, sin x plus y, sin x plus y. Use this formula. In place of x, just consider x plus y. So this is suppose x, then this is equals to what? By using cos pi by 2, cos pi by 2 minus sin x plus y, this cos pi by 2 minus x plus y. Using this formula, our target is what? Sin x plus y. Finding the value of this. Now use this formula. In place of angle x, we use x plus y. So sin of x, reverse, sin of x equals to cos 90 minus x. Sin of x equals to cos 90 minus x means x plus y. Here we can suppose pi by 2 minus x minus y. Cos pi by 2 minus x minus y. Pi by 2 minus x, just adjust like this, pi by 2 minus x minus y. Clear? Now cos a minus b. Cos a minus b, this is cos this. Cos a minus b. Using this formula. So, cos of this, pi by 2 minus x into cos of y, using this formula. So, minus, so here plus cos sin x. sine, using this formula sine of this and sine of y. Using this formula we get in place of x, pi by 2 minus x, in place of y, y. Yes. Now cos 90 minus x, cos 90 minus x, sine x. So sine x cos y. Cos y. Here sine 90 minus x, just also we require sine 90 minus x. Okay, so sine 90 minus x we can find from here. Sine 90 minus x, using this formula, sine x equals to cos 90 minus x. So if we take in place of x 90 minus x, so sine x equals to this, that is sine of this is equals to cos of sine of x equal to this, and in place of x suppose pi by 2 minus x, then sine of this is equals to this, the sine of this is equals to cos of pi by 2 minus in place of x pi by 2 minus x, pi by 2 minus x. So this is equals to what? Cos pi by 2 cancel, minus minus plus x. We have also this formula. What? Sine pi by 2 minus x. This is another formula. Sine 90 minus x equals to cos x. How can get it? From here. Reverse. Sine x equals to this. So sine of this is equals to this according to in place of x pi by 2 minus x. So pi by 2 minus pi by 2 minus x, so pi by 2 cancel, minus minus plus cos x, this formula. Okay, so sine 90 minus x equal to cos x. So here sine 90 minus x equals to what? Cos x plus cos x and sine. Okay, so sine x plus y equals to sine x cos y plus cos x sine y. This is our formula. Sine x cos y plus cos x sin y. Okay, so this is third formula, sin a plus b. Okay, now fourth formula, sin a minus b, sin x minus y. Okay, so here our formula is, how many formula derived? Just like this, sin 90 minus x equals to also cos x. Okay, similarly sine pi by 2 plus x equals to, we can find, just these are proved, and sine 90 plus x equals to, this is a formula, okay, first formula, second formula, third formula, sine a plus b, that is this, sine x plus y. So using this formula you can get value of this, what? Sine x plus y, sine x, that is sin x cos y means sin 90, sin 90 and cos x plus cos x means cos of 90, cos 90 into sin of x. So here cos 90 0, so we get what? Sin 90 plus x, sin 90 plus x equals to sin a plus b, sin a plus b, use this formula, here sin a cos b, cos a sin b, so here sin cos 90 0, so this is 0, this is sin 90, 1, this is cos x. So this is cos x, sin changes to cos, okay. Sin 90 plus x, sin 90 plus x, sin 90, 1. Or here, x, x, cos x, cos x. Cos 90, that is 0, cos 0, 1, cos 90, 0. So that is 0, cos x. This is sin 90 minus x, cos x, and sin 90 plus x. For x is acute, also cos x. Clear? Now, we can find sin x minus y cos y. In place of y, consider minus y. So, sin x cos minus y, cos y, so cos y. Sin minus y, minus y, so here minus sin. Cos x sin y. Okay, this is fourth formula. So remember this formula, very very important. Sin a plus b, sin a minus, cos x plus y, cos x minus y, sin x plus y, sin x minus y. These are the formula. Also we get like this formula. Okay, so remember it. Here we see that in unit circle, this is now, note on this important formula, basic, cos a plus minus b and sin a plus minus b. Okay, these are the important formula. Now here, for getting values of trigonometric functions for particular angles, and just we reduce the angle within the first quadrant. That means what? See, suppose this is what? Pi by 2 radian angles here. Okay, here x, here 0, degree 0, also radian 0. Here pi angle, this is pi, this is pi by 2, this is pi, this is what? Pi, this is pi by 2, and this is what? 3 pi by 2, and this is 2 pi. These are the angle. Okay, this is 3 pi by 2. 3 pi by 2 we know in radian, and in degree 90 degree. What? 180 degree. What? 270 degree. Okay, 360 degree. Clear? These are the angle. Now, vertical line. Vertical line means here in this direction 90, in this direction 270, 3 by 2. And horizontal line means here on the 0 degree or 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi, and etc. Here pi, multiple of pi, pi, 2, 1 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, 5 pi. Here 3 pi by 2, multiple of this. Here multiple of this. Clear? Now for basic formula, 90 minus 90 plus pi minus pi plus 270 minus 270 plus 2 pi plus 2 pi minus, we require formula. So 90 plus 90 minus. 90 minus means here, because we take reduced value, 90 plus or minus here acute angle. Here should be acute angle, if acute angle is there. So 90 minus acute angle, that means lie within this. 90 plus acute angle lie within this. pi minus acute angle lie between this, pi plus acute angle lie between this, 270 or 3 pi by 2 minus acute angle lie between this, 3 pi by 2 plus acute angle lie between this. So here vertical line plus or minus always changes sine to cos, cos to sine, tan to cot, cot to tan, sec to cosec, cosec to sec. Just remember it. Always 90 plus minus changes ratio. But sine, you know what are the sine? Here all positive. Here sine and cosec positive. Here tan and cot are positive. Here cos and sec are positive. These are positive. Clear? Here all are positive. Here only these two are positive and remaining are negative. Here these two are positive, remaining are negative. Here these two are positive, remaining are negative. So for finding the value of trigonometric functions one by one, sine 90 minus x means what? X is acute angle. So 90 minus x is here line. So this is positive, all are positive, so positive. And remember that in vertical line ratio changes, sine to cos, cos to sine, tan to cot, cot to tan, sec to cosec, cosec to sec. That means sine 90 minus this means positive, and sine changes to changes in vertical line means 90 plus minus and 3 pi by 2 plus minus changes. Clear? So sine 90 minus x equals to changes cos and sine positive. Similarly, sine 90 plus x changes sine to cos, but lying here, also here sine is positive. Sine is positive. So you can take sine positive, but ratio is changed because vertical line ratio changed. Similarly, sine cos, then suppose cos. Cos 90 minus x, cos 90 minus x also here positive. Now sine cos turns to sine, so sine. Okay, cos 90 minus x is sine. Similarly, cos 90 plus x here cos negative, but cos will change in sine because in vertical line always changes. Changes sine cos, cos sine, tan cot, cot tan, sec cosec, cosec sec. Okay, so here what will be the formula? Minus sine x. Here one by one you can see all, you can find all the values. Just like, so this is the hint. What is the hint? Vertical. Vertical means what? Pi by 2, 3 pi by 2. Either pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. Same formula. Here, tan 90 minus x. Tan 90 minus x means what? Here. All positive. So tan positive. Sine positive. But tan transferred to cot. So cot x. Similarly, tan pi by 2 plus x. Here. Plus means here. Pi by 2 plus here. Tan is here negative. So minus cot x. Because tan transferred to cot. Same cot. Cot 90 minus x. 90 minus means changes. Cot to 10. 10 to cot, cot to 10. Cot equal to this 10. Okay? 10 is. But sine is here. 90 minus x. Cot 90 minus x. So cot 90 minus x means here. All are positive. So positive sine. Now cot 90 plus x equals to cot changes because pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, in both there are changes. So sine is here their cot is negative, so negative. So sin cos a cot 10. Similarly, you can write for cos x a. So sec of 90 minus x, what will be the formula for sec 90 minus x? Sec changes cosec, cosec changes sec. So vertical line changes. So vertical lines 90 minus x, vertical lines here positive. Sec changes cosec, so cosec. Here sec pi by 2 plus x equals to also changes cosec x, but 90 plus x here, sec is here negative. So negative. Similarly, you can write for cosec. What? Cosec 90 minus x equals to cosec. Cosec 90 minus x equals to sec x, because changes vertical. And sine, this 90 minus x, positive, positive. So cosec 90 plus x equals to cosec changes to sec. But sine 90 plus x here, cosec positive, so positive. So this, by using technique, here plus minus changes, here plus minus changes. That means, suppose we take angle just like this. Okay, this is the technique for finding value of trigonometric functions. So remember it, always very very important part. Okay, so here suppose sine of 3 pi by 2 minus x. 3 pi by 2 minus x means this line, vertical line. Minus x, that means here angle is, x is acute angle, here. So sine 3 pi by 2 minus x equals to vertical changes, sine changes cos. Okay, now sine, you will recite sine, here sine of sine, sine, sine of cos, sine, these two are positive, all are negative, so sine negative, so this is equal to negative. Similar, sine of 3 pi by 2 plus x equals to what? 3 pi by 2, that is vertical, plus or minus in both changes. So sine will change in cos of sine this side. 3 pi by 2 plus means here. Here sine is negative. So is negative. Now suppose cot of 3 pi by 2 plus x. Cot of 3 pi by 2 plus x. How can you get value? 3 pi by 2 plus means here, x is acute angle. Clear? So here, here cot is negative. So negative. But vertical line, so changes. Negative 10x. Now suppose sec of 3 pi by 2 minus x. So how can we get the value? Sec 3 pi by 2 means vertical. Pi by 2 and 3 by 2. So there, changes, sec changes to cosec, so cosec. And you have to decide sine. What will be the sine? Here, here sec x negative, so minus. Minus. So by using this technique, you can find the value of trigonometric functions reducing to acute angle. Okay. Now this is vertical line. And on horizontal line, means what? Pi minus, pi plus, 2 pi plus, 2 pi minus, 2 pi plus acute angle. 2 pi plus acute angle means line here. 2 pi minus acute angle means line here. Pi minus acute angle means line here. Pi plus acute angle means line here. So in vertical line changes. And sine will decide like this. Horizontal line, no changes. And sine will decide like this. Okay, that means if we take, okay, this is the main step for changing. Suppose sine of pi sine of pi plus x. So what you can write here? Remember, pi plus minus means this is horizontal line. Here no changes means sine cos cos tan cot sec cosec. Okay, so sine pi plus x here, sine x y pi plus or minus 2 pi plus or minus sine cos sec, so no changes. But sine of ratio here, pi plus here, sine negative sine negative. Suppose sec of 2 pi minus x, sec of 2 pi minus x, 2 pi minus means here sec positive, so sine positive, and sec changes to sec because 2 pi plus minus ratio not changes. So sec, so sec x. Clear? Just I have discussed now pi plus minus or pi by 2 plus minus or 3 pi by 2 plus minus. This is in vertical line ratio. Trigonometric functions are changes, and sine accordingly unit circle. All are positive in first quadrant, second sine cosec positive and all are negative. Third quadrant, 10 cot positive and all are negative. Cos sec are positive in fourth quadrant and all are negative. There are sine, but in vertical, that is pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2 plus minus changes. Sine cos sine, etc. Okay. Suppose we can find the value of function also by using other formula, just like this. Suppose sine pi plus x, we know how can you get this value of this pi plus, that means 10, no changes, that means 10x, and also sine, how can you identify sine? You can identify sine pi plus acute angle, that is in third quadrant. So 10 is positive in third quadrant, so 10x. Here, suppose 10 pi minus x, how can you get? No changes, so 10x. And also pi minus means first quadrant, second quadrant pi minus, just second quadrant 10 negative, so negative. You can also get the value of this by using basic sine and cos, because by using sine and cos we can get all the remaining four functions. How? Sine pi plus x equals to what? 10 pi plus x, sine pi plus x upon cos pi plus x. And we know sine pi plus x, second quadrant, sine positive, no changes, sine x. Cos pi plus x means sine pi plus x, sorry, minus sine x, because third quadrant. Cos pi plus x in third quadrant, negative. No changes, cos x, minus minus plus, 10x, so 10x. Similarly, 10 equals cot equals to cos by sine, means if we know about sine and cos, then we can get all the remaining four functions. 10 equals to sine by cos, cot equal to cos by sine, sec equal to 1 by cos, and cosec equals to 1 by sine. So basic sine and cos are required. So this technique, vertical, that is pi by 2 plus minus, 3 pi by 2 plus minus, no changes are there, and sine are getting by using unit circle method. Okay, very very important. Up to now we have discussed about formula pi by 2 plus minus and pi plus minus how can we get the values of trigonometric functions? By converting to function of acute angle and using basic table. So here just in this class, just take 2-3 questions from exercise 3.3. So first questions, I think you can solve it, because sin pi by 6, cos pi by 3 and tan pi by 4, they are from basic table. Pi by 4 means 45 degree, pi by 3 means 60 and pi by 6 means 30. You can get a value. Okay. Question second, here prove that 2 sin square pi by 6, we have to prove that 2 sin square pi by 6 plus cosec square 7 pi by 6, cosec square 7 pi by 6 into cos square pi by 3, cos square pi by 3 equals to 3 by 2. Just we have to prove this. So here we see that this is basic angle, this is basic angle, but 7 pi by 6. So for getting this value 7 pi by 6, here left hand side take 2 sin pi by 6 square plus cosec 7 pi by 6 square, cosec square and cos pi by 3 square. This is left hand side. So from direct table we can put the value 2 sin pi by 6 means sin 30. Sin 30 means 1 by 2 square plus here cosec 7 pi by 6. 7 by 6 means greater than 1. So pi plus pi by 6 we can write. Cosec pi plus pi by 6. 7 pi by 6 square. Here cos pi by 3 means cos 60 means 1 by 2 square. 1 by 2 square. Okay. So we can see 2 square means 1 by 2 plus here cosec pi plus pi by 6. Pi plus pi minus. Always no changes. So cosec cosec. So here cosec pi by 6, this is acute angle between 0 to 90. So we can write like this, but its sign, what is its sign? Cosec pi plus, that is in pi plus means here, third part. Here cosec negative. So 10 get positive or remaining a negative, so negative. Square, 1 by 4. Okay, so 1 by 2 square, 1 by 4. So now we can write cosec pi by 6 means cosec 30. Cosec 30 means 2. Sin 30, 1 by 2. Cosec 30, 2. So 1 by 2 minus minus plus. So 2 into 1 by 4. 2 square. Yeah, square is also there, na? Square. Minus minus plus and cosec pi by 6 means 2. 2 square. So 1 by 2 plus 4 by 4 equals to what? 1 by 2 plus 1 equals to 3 by 2 equals to right hand side. So you can get the value. Similarly, question third. You can see question third. Here, what is given? Question third, there are 5 pi by 6 also. 1 pi by 6 and pi by 6, you know, 30 basic value and 5 pi by 6. Cosec 5 pi by 6. Cosec 5 pi by 6. It can be converted like this. Cosec 5 pi by 6. 5 by 6 means less than pi. So pi minus pi by 6 we can write. Pi minus pi by 6. Here pi plus, pi minus, no changes. Function cosec pi by 6. Okay. No. But sin here pi minus in second quadrant. Cosec in second quadrant. Positive. So this cosec pi by 6 means what? 2. 30. Sin 30, 1 by 2, cosec pi by 6, 2. So use this. Similarly, in fourth, 3 pi by 4. What? Sin 3 pi by 4. In question 4. Just see, in question 4, there is given what? Sin 3 pi by 4. So sin 3 pi by 4. Here also sin 3 by 4 is, you can get value 3 by 4 means less than 1. So you can write sin pi minus pi by 4. So you can get 4 pi minus pi means 3 pi by 4. So here sin pi minus, no changes. So sin pi plus minus. So sin pi by 4. And sin in, this is pi minus. So in second quadrant, pi minus. So in here sin positive, so positive. So you can get value 1 by root. Use this value. So you can solve these 4 questions. Okay. So your work is what? Write all the formulas. Just I have discussed in today's class. Write all the formulas and do these 4 questions. And make video file and send to me for your attendance. Okay.